Good morning, Life Center. It's an honor and pleasure for me to be with you this morning of 2021. Praise the Lord. This morning, I want to talk to you about good news. We live in a world saturated with information, news all over, trying to grab our attention. And if we are not careful, we become immersed in that information, in that news, and that becomes our reality. Let me give you an example. This passage in the scripture portrays what could happen when our attention is immersed in our circumstances and not what God in what God is doing. Let's read with me, or let's go with me to Exodus chapter 6, verse 6 to 8. The word of God says, "Therefore says, say to the people of Israel, I am the Lord. I will free you from your oppression. I will rescue you from your slavery in Egypt. I will redeem you with a powerful arm and great acts of judgment. I will claim you as my own people, and I will be your God. Then you will know that I am the Lord your God, who has freed you from your oppression in Egypt. I will bring you into the land I swore to give to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. I will give it to you as your very own possession. I am the Lord." As we know, the people of Israel had been in slaves in Egypt, and they had cried out to God for a savior, for a redeemer, for someone to come and free them from their slavery. And the word of God says that the Lord listened to them and he sent Moses, and we just read the promise. However, when the response came from God, when he told them, I'm going to free you, I'm going to take you, you are going to be my possession, their answer was the following. So Moses told the people of Israel what the Lord has said, but they refused to listen anymore. They have become too discouraged by the brutality of their slavery. Their circumstances, what they have been living in, what they have been hearing every single day, have become who they were, that when the good news came, they were not able to listen because of the discouragement. So I encourage you today to listen to what God is doing, to just try to silence the voices of the world or what is around us or the news, whatever you see around you, and fix your eyes in the Lord and what he is doing, because the good news are that he is your father, that you are his children, that he is your healer, that he is your deliverer, that he is your provider, that he is your joy, your peace, that he is love. Those are the good news of the gospel, and they are for us today, and we need to receive them, and we need to just immerse ourselves in those good news, because even when we don't see it, God is working. Even when we don't feel it, God is doing something greater than we can think and imagine. So let's just focus on what God is doing and try to hear his voice every day. Because as children of God, our reality is a reality of hope. Because even as we live in this world, the Bible says that we are not of the world, as Jesus is not of the world. That you can find it in John 17, 16. We need to silence the outside voices and listen to what the Lord is doing in our midst. We have been chosen and we have been called for hope. Even we don't see it, God is doing great things in our midst. In time of distress and uncertainty, let's focus on what God is doing today. And let me tell you just a brief testimony. Around 1998, between 1998 and year 2000, Edgar received a prophecy through Cindy Jacobs that he was going to become a millionaire. And at the time I thought, oh wow, that's great. I'm gonna get married with this guy and he's gonna be a millionaire. But what we don't know is that God prepares for times that we don't really know. And as you know, we have a ministry where we give or distribute food in very low-income neighborhoods. Since probably 2017, we have been doing this. And just to give you some data, yes, in 2000, 2017, we gave away at the end of the year about 400,000 pounds of food, and year after year that amount of food has been growing. In 2018, it was about 900,000 pounds of food a year, and in 2019, 5 million pounds of food over that. Why I'm telling you this? Because last year, in 2020, when the pandemic hit, we were wondering, what's going to happen? Are we going to be able to continue feeding the people, given that, doing the work of the Lord? And when it seemed that it was just gonna be hard, God did something supernaturally. We were able to grow exponentially. And we not only focused in Harrisburg and the region around us, but we grew all over the East Coast. And at the end of the year, we were able to give about 32 million pounds of food in a year that everything was against us. We grew exponentially, 32 million pounds of food. And if I put that in money-wise, the value will be about $53 million that came through our hands and were given to the people. Why I'm telling you this? Because in 2018, in the year 2000, let's say, God gave this prophecy, you're going to be a millionaire. And when we were doing those numbers, I told Edgar, it came to the realization, it's like, Edgar, we are millionaires. Those are the good news. God has given us a promise 20 years ago, and we're seeing the fulfillment of that. And God had set it for a time like this, for a time where He knew that there was going to be a need, and we will need a millionaire. So we are millionaires. We're giving that away, these people. And you know that? That money didn't even come from us. It's God's provision. I'm telling you, whatever God puts in your hand, do it, because God is with you. And the good news is that if God is for you, who is against you? May the Lord bless you. Remember that you are His child and that He is with you. Good news, we have a great Father. God bless you and have a wonderful day.